morning, everybody. Now begins the
Operation Packing.
Yeah, which it's Operation Everybody Packing in the House at Once, while I'm also trying to do laundry, which is a very delicate operation.
Hi guys, it's Jake here, and it's really echoing my apartment, but I'm about to leave for my trip around Europe for the detour. I have my bag. I'm actually really, really nervous. I don't know, I'm just about to fly. I think my flight's like a good 25 hours or something, and I have to take 3 of them. I think I fly to Singapore first, then Finland, and then across to Berlin, because Berlin's my first stop.
Getting some final puppy playtime in, because I'm not gonna see the puppy for 3 weeks, no. And he's like, yay, but I'm going to, right? I'm going to.
Yeah, it breaks my heart.
I want you to go with this puppy. I want you to go with us.
Bye, puppy.
Bye, puppy.
This is making me really sad.
Push, grab a kiss. Hey, I want a kiss.
Bye. He's like, where are you going? What are you doing?
We're getting ready to leave now. And Jason and Ava are here.
I've just arrived in Changi Airport in Singapore. I think it was like a 9-hour flight. I'm not even halfway yet. I'm so tired.
It's raining in LA because LA is sad that we're leaving.
So sad that you're leaving.
The sky is crying.
We have left the apartment. There was some frantic last minute packing. Left Kevin with Dobby, and we are now at the airport.
Yeah. Oh, hi.
And you're behind the scenesing.
Behind the scenesing! Yeah, wait, big kiss. Yeah, so we're about to check into our flight on Lufthansa. And who's excited?
I'm so excited.
Are you so excited?
I wanna like wake up and be there. Like,
yeah, it's not gonna be that easy.
I've met Finland in one piece. And here's my gate. It's about an hour until I have to board to go to Berlin.
So here we are. We were like all rushing to get to the airport, and we rushed to find out that as soon as we showed up to the airport, our plane was taking off.
Because we got the wrong information.
Yeah, but it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. So maybe they're coming up with some creative solutions on how to get us to Munich.
No, they're gonna turn the plane around.
They're turning the plane around.
Yeah, and they're gonna come back, refuel, and pick us up.
Sabina actually called the pilot and said, you need to turn around.
The pilot was getting so many tweets to turn
around. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we told everyone, tweeted the pilot.
Tweet at...
Oh, no, he was texting and driving.
He was texting and driving.
So we got it figured out, guys. Lufthansa actually was able to redo our flight and get us onto Swiss Airlines.
Welcome to Zurich.
Hi.
Where we have our first layover of the tour.
We made it to Switzerland. We're in Zurich. Yeah.
We took a detour.
Yes! We're here.
Welcome to Germany.
We got really excited. We got to see Jake. We hadn't seen Jake in a long time.
In forever. It was a small airport, too. I was very struck by how small that airport was.
Yeah, yeah.
The fact that
the baggage claim was, like, literally
right next to the gate.
Right off the gate. So we were like, okay, well, this is really easy. So we grabbed our stuff and we went.
While we were at the airport, it was still, it just felt like we were in a part of LA that didn't look like LA.
Yeah, or part of America that didn't look like America.
And then we left and I was like, oh, okay, we're in Germany, I guess.
Yeah. I was over the moon, so happy. Like, I love traveling, and I love traveling through Europe, and last time I did it by myself. And to meet some of my favorite people who I have met online to do it with me is so exciting. Well, for me to do it with them, actually. So, yeah, it was amazing.
Yay! Everyone has a camera.
This one doesn't even have Zoom, but for real, though.
What?
Yeah.
Who needs Zoom, though?
I do.
Yes.
And we went to dinner.
So now we have all the gang together. And we're gonna go get some food. I know, yay!
We got our food. It looks super delicious.
One and then the other one.
Right.
Yum.
Sounds like my
And Ken got
heart and lung.
I'm eating the soul of animals.
We're walking home after dinner. It was fantastic. Did you guys all enjoy your dinner? Yeah.
It's a real simple evening and then the jet lag hit us.
But I am exhausted right now.
I'm ready for sleep.
Same.
Can you wrap this up, please, Miles?
Okay, so then tomorrow we're gonna explore
Berlin.
Yep.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Good morning, Will.
Good morning. Hi, hello.
He's working on the videos.
Yes.
Trying to get the uploads set and ready.
Look at the morning in Germany.
It's
a German morning.
It's kind of dreary.
I'm not running late. Jake is running late. What are you trying to find?
Does anyone have toothpaste?
I have toothpaste. There's my bag.
I have to say, I'm actually pretty impressed because we have like 30 gays here and we're
only running.
We're like pretty on time right now.
We're only, well, gay on time is like 30 minutes behind.
Hi everyone and welcome to Berlin with the gays. So today we're out exploring, like I said we would, and I'm feeling much better. We can't walk that way. Everyone's being really mean to me, Miles.
I'm sorry.
It's just but you were just so loud.
Everyone, I know, because I'm excited to be here.
We're all excited.
Where are we going today, guys?
I don't even know.
We're going.
We don't know where we're going. We're getting something to eat.
We're getting something to eat right now.
Yeah.
We're gonna go get some breakfast brunch thing, like we told you, and then we have a tour of the concentration camp today. So that's pretty exciting. There goes Miles. In front.
Where are we going again?
Just go. Mentioned there's camp.
Oh, okay.
So we're on our way to the Sony Center, and Sabina told us a bit of information. This is where the wall used to be. This is where the line is. And this whole area used to be kept flat. There weren't any buildings here, so that whenever people tried to jump the fence, there wasn't anything in the way to pick them off. So, that's wild.
Is this where the wall used to be?
Yeah, 1961 to 1989. Wow, that's so crazy.
Berlin has been one of those places that I've always wanted to visit just because I've heard so much about the history, not just of Germany, but I mean, Berlin has been such a significant place, not, you know, for so long, for so many different reasons. You know, everything from, you know, you hear about Nazi Germany to the Cold War and, you know, the fact that it was divided in two at one point.
And then people also talk about how progressive it is there. So, I don't know, that's kind of an interesting mix. It's a very severe history, but then you have a lot of progressive culture and
but if you
there.
Go back far enough, Berlin actually used to be an extremely sexually progressive place before all that stuff happened.
Right.
So it was just really, really cool to see. Like, when you learn about all this stuff, it's so abstract because you're just learning about, you know, all these things in faraway lands. You know, we're living in the United States. None of it happened
anywhere
near us.
So it's like a fairy tale to us.
But to go there and to see the line through the city where the Berlin Wall used to be and to see the sections that are still standing. And to
see the Holocaust Memorial. Whenever you walk up to the Holocaust Memorial, it immediately looks like some kind of modern gravesite.
Yeah, it's grim. It's extremely grim.
You see
but
it
in a very subtle sort of way.
And you can't help but notice that the shapes of the columns are the perfect size of a gravesite and like the perfect size of what you would need to bury someone in the ground. But then you start walking in the memorial and the columns of cement begin to rise above you because the ground actually undulates and goes into the ground, and you whenever you're in the middle of it, you're almost suffocating from how severe and how real the tragedy of the Holocaust is.
Walking through just the cold concrete statues was just it gives you a real feeling of disorientation.
It was powerful. I don't know if I can think of it.
Even just the memorial itself was powerful.
Because I remember seeing it off of Gunnarola's videos and him walking through it, and it was just a whole nother thing to actually be there and walk through it yourself.
Well, the book, it said that the whole point of it was to make you feel like uneasy.
Yeah, it says a maze of 2,711 sarcophagi-like concrete columns rising in somber silence from the undulating ground. I mean, it's crazy. Whenever you look at it from the street, it looks like everything's maybe just a couple of feet high, and then you get into it and it's so deep.
So much deeper.
But besides that,
just chilling with my hunties at the president's house.
And now we've made it to the Brandenburg Gate. So this is important. It symbolizes the reunification of Germany after the Cold War and the wall was taken down.
Yep.
It was originally built in 1791
as a
gate to the royal gate to another city. Crazy. But now it symbolizes the reunification of Germany.
Because that was also the gate for between East and West Germany.
Right.
I love horses, but I'm really scared of them.
Same. They have such big mouths, like they can bite your whole hand off.
Here is the Reichstag. This is where German's parliament is.
It's actually such a beautiful building, though.
It's fantastic, yeah.
It is. Yeah, I like it.
It is.
And it's the goddess Germania. Ow. So she's like the Beyonce of war.
Here we are in an underground tunnel to the Victory Tower, feeling our fantasy, Doc.
See, I told you we were feeling our fantasy.
And if you walk up these stairs and you just take a little gander up, this is kind of cool. You have like this massive statue. So this is the Victory statue, right? To commemorate the Revolutionary Wars that unified the parts of Germany into Germany.
It's so pretty. Let me see if you can see in there. Yes. Can we go to the top? Oh. Never, never stop. Yeah.
So the concentration camp, first of all, you hear about them and they're almost like nightmares in a children's story that you hear about.
Yeah.
But there's a lot like the rest of Europe. You don't have anything to connect it to because there's nothing quite like it.
It's so heinous. It's so awful that your brain just doesn't know how to process it. And your brain just almost tries to dismiss it and just say, oh, you know, it's whatever. It didn't actually kind of happen. Even though you know it did, but it's just your brain just can't wrap itself around the concept of something so awful.
That was something I never experienced before in my life. And I had known about how... So I went to the Jewish Museum last time I was in Berlin. I read about it, but to actually go and be told and see proof of what happened and that was a real thing at a point in time is absolutely insane.
Like, you could tell, like, everybody was having a conversation, like, they were excited to be there, but they didn't want to use the word excited because something terrible happened there. So everyone was just...
I think everyone was looking forward to being enlightened.
Yeah, that's what we all said, decided upon. So it was really eye-opening.
Right. Yeah, I mean, the closest we have to it is what we see in movies. And even then, you're like, okay, this is just like some Hollywood gimmick. There's no way that things were actually ever that bad. And then you go and you visit, and it's... It takes your breath away. The amount of time and effort that went into creating these places
and planning them and building them and
just for the sake of torture.
And when the tour guide was giving us like numbers and like how many, like the sheer amount of people that went through this every day and like how she would personalize it by showing us pictures of people that actually went through this and stuff. It was really, really difficult.
So this is probably the toughest part of the concentration camp. So
the GDR, they destroyed the majority of this industrial yard, but the outline of it is pretty still intact. In this back corner was where the gas chamber was. These people were literally killed because they were different, and I can't like wrap my head around that. That there were so many people that were convinced that that was okay. And it's just really hard. And here is the memorial to commemorate, in memory of the victims of Sachsenhausen.
I stopped filming inside the concentration camp because it was just a bit much. I think a lot of us, like even for Will.
Yeah, I was vlogging and I just started crying.
Yeah. So yeah, I just stopped. I don't think I even said anything in the videos. I don't know, it wasn't right. Yeah, so you guys can see it, but yeah. So, but we're heading back to Berlin now, and we're going to get something to eat, I think.
So look at the train station lit up at night in Berlin. It's the gay train station, yay!
Anyways, we're on our way to dinner at this Bavarian place that's supposed to be really bomb. And Lucas has been pretty much trash talking ever since that we've been hanging out that like Bavarian beer is supposed to be like the best. And so now Lucas gets a chance to back up all that talk. All that talk. I just hope it lives up to it, is all I'm saying.
Here.
Holy.
So, this is actually mine.
OMG.
Yeah.
All right, let's do this.
Literally, why did I think that I would handle that? All right.
That's how you do it.
Girl's hungry.
She's so hungry. Pork knuckle.
A girl's gonna eat.
Moosh knuckle.
I'm going wrong.
Yes, I'm so tired. So I'm gonna go to bed and snuggle up to my fiance.
Morning, guys.
Good morning, RJ.
So last night, Miles had my camera in his bag and then he took it out of his bag when we went to dinner, so I didn't get to bring my camera to dinner.
We're going to some street.
Do you remember what it was called?
We're going shopping.
I never know.
KDV.
KDV. KDV, which is German for Department Store of the West, because this was part of West Berlin. And this is one of the very large department stores. So as you can tell, we weren't allowed to film in that store.
We bought some really yummy food. So I got this baguette with cheese because y'all know I love cheese. And I also got some German sausage. Just so good.
I got a quiche because I'm a grandma. So, you know. What did you get?
Sausages.
Oh, of course you did.
Up. We just went shopping and I didn't film it because I was too busy trying on clothes. And now we're just heading back to the apartment. We're gonna drop off our stuff because we all actually shopped up a storm. Yes. So yeah.
We made a pretty decent dent.
Yeah.
So we're on our way to get some currywurst and some like food because we're hungry, right?
The currywurst at the place called
The
Worst
Currywurst was the best.
Yeah, the worst currywurst was the best, pretty much.
We're all about to get some currywurst with Fritz, Pomfritz. I think it's fries.
Oh, everybody.
Yes!
Fucking love currywurst.
Yes.
Currywurst, I mean, it's if you haven't had currywurst, oh my god.
It just takes you back to your childhood because it's almost like you have hot dogs and ketchup and fries whenever you're a kid, but then this takes it to the adult level.
And adds like other flavors spices to it that make it like so good.
For the camera.
Oh my god.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh my god. We have made our way into the Rittersport store.
Rittersport.
Yeah, I forgot.
Yeah. And Ken is gonna make his own chocolate bar.
Easily my favorite food has been Rittersport.
Rittersport, yeah, the chocolate. Oh, it's so
there's
good.
A particular, because first of all, they come in like 1,000 flavors, and there's one that has a cookie on the inside of it, and it reminds me of like a reverse Milano, and it's delicious, and I've had maybe 20 of them.
So much chocolate. So much chocolate.
RJ's in line right now. He's wanting to bathe in it. And I got a variety pack.
Let me whisper in your ear. Yeah, come closer, baby. Come closer.
You like that chocolate? I got some chocolate, some Ritter Sport Boundish. It's real good, baby.
Just like talking to Sabina about how this is crazy. You never have this kind of stuff in the States.
This is a cathedral and people worship here.
Thank you for that very thorough lesson in history, Miles. Gallery.
Many small people who in many small places do many small things that can alter the face of the world. That's so crazy.
They know we're here.
We're running out of time, we've got to go to dinner. It's actually quite late. It's like 7:30 at night.
It's interesting.
Yeah, I'm still really tired. I think we all just have like jet lag still.
Oh my god. So exhausted.
I'm exhausted.
Yeah. Who's exhausted?
So real.
Who's exhausted? That's we have been joined by a good friend, Anya. Say hey, Anya.
Hi.
Yay!
Bye.
Well guys, it's been a really long day and we just got back from eating and tomorrow we have like 5 hours of meet and greets, so I need my beauty sleep so I can look cute tomorrow.
Oh no, the squirrel's so cute, it's going away, no, bye, no, 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 I want to keep you, come with me.
We have two YouTubers in a room that need to get ready and we have no idea what we're wearing. How you doing, B?
Good, good.
I love what you're wearing.
Thanks. I've actually worn this before.
We're all really nervous, actually. It's gonna be a great day. It's like 5 hours of meeting and hanging out with people. Will, you ready?
Yeah.
Can I throw it out?
Yeah. I'm nervous though.
Are you?
Yeah, I actually am.
We came all this way.
Yeah, definitely.
And this is the first meetup. How are you guys feeling?
Excited.
I think it's the same way. I'm excited.
This is Ken excited.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Ken excited. What about you, Miles and Nick, who aren't talking?
I'm just ready to get out there, honestly.
Yeah? Get this party started. walking back now to our apartment, and there's a very large dog, and I'm totally convinced it's Fang from Harry Potter.
Look at this dog. He's growling.
Hi.
If he's growling, he's like, he's not, he's like, don't touch me.
We're going to the club.
To turn. Okay,
can't
believe
we're in another country.
You can do it now. Vlog it.
We're about to get sent into, like, what's it called?
Be a good vlogger.
Yeah.
He's pretty decent. Trying to be a good vlogger for once.
Yeah, he's pretty decent.
Oh, there they are. They're over there.
He has a steady camera and everything.
Uh-huh.
Good morning, RJ.
Good morning, Will.
And good morning, Chef Simpson. Yeah, guten Morgen. Or it's not going to be guten Morgen for much longer because we have officially packed up and we are ready to make our way to Italy.
Goodbye, cherry blossom. Goodbye, cucumber salad. Goodbye, world. Goodbye, Berlin. Play ending theme music for America's Next Top Model when someone gets eliminated. Wanna be on top, wanna be on
top, wanna be on top, wanna be. We're leaving.
Don't know when we'll be back in Berlin. Saying goodbye to Stefan Lucas was so hard.
So hard. Because,
I mean, they kind of been, like, part of our life for the past, like, what, month and a half or something.
Yeah.
So, it wasn't until we were on the train and we left that we were like, wow, we left someone behind. Like, something
it felt
right.
Yeah, it felt like they were part of the group, and then all of a sudden we're like, oh, no.
And then, like, you realize, oh, no, they have to go about their life now. And, it's always, hindsight is always 20/20. You always realize exactly, like, what kind of effect someone had on you whenever they're gone, and they almost became like a permanent fixture in our house.
They were
to wake up and to not have like Stefan Lucas there.
Yeah, I mean, me personally, it's like they felt like, you know, younger siblings almost.
Yeah,
just because, you know, they're younger than us, and we, you know, we're almost like
family.
Yeah, it just because we lived under the same roof for so long, and it was just
But that's what it's all about. Like, we wouldn't have met them if we hadn't done the tour last year. And hopefully we'll be able to make some new friends like that this year.
And did make similar connections this year, so.
This is certainly an adventure, guys. We have boarded our train. Yeah, close the door. Here we are, yeah.
Legit Harry Potter status.
Legit. It's not Harry Potter status. Like, yep. This is exactly what you take on your way to Hogwarts. I'm a little nervous, not gonna lie, about this luggage rack. But as long as I'm on this side, I guess I'm cool, you know?
Yeah, just you guys.
As the three of you look up like
ducking cover. Actually, nah. I'm more nervous about this guy right here.
What do you mean, like ours?
This guy right here.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Are we gonna live?
Yeah.
We had to open this window because it's gonna get hot. It's gonna get hot.
We had been on that train for 16 hours apparently.
Yeah, I did not sleep in that train ride at all.
No. I actually got some sleep.
Like
a couple hours. I was really good, but my butt was hurting and my legs hurt. And then we finally got to here, Italy, and we were all just like, and we didn't really know where let me speak for myself. I didn't really know, like, where we were. Like, I knew we were in Florence, but I didn't know that, like,
you didn't know it was
like,
Italy?
Yeah, like, I didn't know what the surroundings were.
Okay.
Not like I didn't know it was Italy.
Yeah.
So.
I didn't know what to expect, so. Mm-hmm.
And then we finally walked outside.
And then when we walked out, I was like, oh my god, it's so beautiful. I mean, the surroundings are stunning.
They are.
So, but when we got here, it was really early in the morning and there was no one around. So we were just like walking around and I was like, oh, this is such a nice, peaceful city. Mm-hmm. This is great.
I'm like,
literally, what is this car? This car would be so useful in LA. Yeah. Sorry, I can't pick you up. Like, this is the only thing. I mean, you can kind of fit in the back if you really want to, but like, there's just enough room for me.
We decided to go on a little stroll through the city. Such pretty buildings.
I love how we'll just like walk by a place and get wafted with the most amazing smells.
Ugh. Yeah, I cannot wait for the food, but the driving here is a little crazy. These people are super aggressive. But, are we on, we're on a, we found a river.
Found a river. Whoa. Whoa.
This is so
whoa, ho, ho, ho.
Like out of a storybook, I guess. Like the streets are so tiny and the sidewalks are so tiny and the buildings. It looks like a pop-up book.
Yeah.
Been told to come explore one of the central markets here in Firenze.
And I was like, fish, just raw fish, lots of raw fish and raw meats, mostly raw fish.
That's one of my favorite things. I got half pistachio and half pignoli, which is pistachio and pine nuts. I know.
Food so far has been really cheap.
Yeah, a cup of coffee, €1.20.
I might never leave. I might just never leave this place. The men are beautiful, the weather's beautiful, the city's beautiful, the food is good, the wine is amazing, the ice cream, the gelato is phenomenal, the fashion. I'm in love. I'm in love. And now some of the group are headed to a ristorante to experience some Italian, good Italian cooking for the first time.
Are you excited? Yeah. So this came in like less than 5 minutes.
Like we just ordered.
I got prosciutto pizza. Oh my gosh. I
just received our $2 box wine from Italy.
That's, you know what makes me happy?
Yeah.
Oh, it's actually really good.
Is it?
Mm. Mess. So I think it's about 8 a.m. right now, 8:30 maybe. I just went to the market and I bought a couple of things to
cook for breakfast.
Look at this, you guys. Ken was kind enough to whip up some frittata and asparagus and what is this?
On the Tuscan salad.
Tuscan salad for breakfast.
Excuse you, I help with the salad.
True, but he was the exec chef on all this, yes.
Frickety fresh.
Fresh tomatoes.
That's what life is all about.
So, I decided to do a little bit of a photo shoot.
Guys, it is a beautiful morning in Florence. It was kind of overcast earlier, but the clouds are starting to burn away, and we have some pretty exciting news. We were expecting my friend Luca to show up at around like 2, but I guess he's early. I think his train's changed or something. And we're going down this way, right?
Should we wait for everyone?
Oh, not everyone's here? Oh, okay, let's wait. Look, guys, we found Luca. He's so shy. Hi, look, Luca. He's gonna be our guide while we're here in Italy. So we're trying to figure out what we're gonna do today in Florence. We're gonna go to Pisa tomorrow. He's gonna come with us to Rome. You're basically like our Moses now.
So, they think you're a model. And she's like,
Modella.
Done.
Everyone's just like, Miles is stopping traffic here. Bitch, I'm fleek.
At the end of the street, you guys can see there's like a tall tower that's part of the Duomo, which is one of the largest domes in the world that is made out of brick, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And Luca was telling me a little bit about it.
Yeah, it's really old. It took 170 years to be built.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's from the, I think, 13th century.
So like, it was 1300s to like 14th century. And it took about 200 years to complete. So like, can you imagine how long, like, some people lived, they started working on this and never saw its completion.
Yep.
But
like, one part of it is from like 1060, I think.
Oh, wow.
Like,
that's so crazy because we, like, that's older than our entire country.
This is insane. This building is art.
Look at how big this place is. It's absolutely crazy.
The dome was amazing. We went to the dome pretty much every day since we've been here.
Just walking past it.
Yes, a lot of walking past it. The first time that I looked at it, I saw that the church and the dome next to it, and I was like, this was supposed to be built like centuries upon centuries ago. Like, what? Like,
I know, and it's so beautiful and so large.
That was like so big. Like, I don't know. I'm really eloquent. Like, it was, how did they build with that? It must have been so expensive.
It was mind-blowing.
Yeah.
And, I mean, when we were like, oh, let's go up and let's climb the dome, I was kind of thinking to myself, I'm like,
you don't want to do it.
I was like, I mean, okay. But then we did it, and it was 100%, I think, a highlight.
Yeah. Like,
yeah. This is crazy. Here at the top of the dome, right there, that's the campanile, that's the bell tower to this church. And you see like a perspective all around.
I felt like I just died when I went up there. I was like, oh my god, this is it. Like, it was
seeing everything and, you know, seeing that perspective of Florence was just crazy.
Florencia. Florence. In the back, which is awesome because I've been wanting to see, like, the full scale of this town. It's so massive. They say you can't get lost here, but I disagree.
Cute little, you know, small little ristorantes in the town. No, just kidding. Yeah, we all got, like, look at our, we all got some pasta. They have, like, a first course and then a second course. And then you have, like
a third course, I think. I think,
yeah, even a third course.
So, Florence was the start of our...
I don't want to go to food because I can jabber about this for hours. The food was fresh. I swear to God, I mean, tomatoes came from America. But when I had a tomato in Florence, I was convinced I've never had a tomato in my life. Like, I was just, this is it. This is the first time I ever had tomatoes.
So I don't think I've ever had, like, fresh pasta before. And it's like a spiritual experience. Mm-hmm. It's something else. And just, all the roots are really really rich and full of, lots of fresh tomatoes. Mm-hmm. I didn't know tomatoes could be so delicious.
Yeah, well, you've been missing out. I've known all along, so.
Yeah, you love a tomato.
Yes, I do. Love a good, nice tomato. It was...
Tomato.
I love...
Potato.
I was loving. I was like, buy me all the tomatoes. Give them to me now.
Are you copying
I still
me?
Have an extra box.
I'm you say tomatoes.
Me. I say tomatoes.
Yeah.
Why, did you think I say tomatoes?
No, I say tomatoes.
Why can't I say tomatoes?
You can say tomatoes. You can say tomatoes. That's fine.
I'm gonna say tomatoes.
Okay. Anyway, I'm enjoying the wine with every meal. I think that every meal I have a glass of wine because I have an excuse to drink.
I mean, that's smart though, because, you know, just...
I'm just trying to, like...
Is it when, different when, wines?
I mean, yes and no, but, like, when am I ever going to go be in Italy
drinking wine.
Italian wine, doing my thing, like...
None of us are judging you, I don't think.
You are, though.
Like, no, we're not. Like, we're just, like, looking at, like, don't drink too much wine, bitch.
Well, maybe we'll have it last time.
Gonna look us so crazy right now, your love's gonna look us so crazy right now.
So we're finally getting some gelato from Luca's favorite gelateria. Look at this. God, look at that, guys.
Look, it's melting. It's so good, though. It's so good.
Will needed both hands for his... What'd you get? You got the...
Stracciatella crema.
And how do you feel about that?
Delicious, though.
If I'm going to take anything away from Italy, it's been the food, the really, really, really attractive gentleman, and the beautiful streets and the architecture.
So we're at the train station, obviously, we got our tickets, ready to go to Pisa, and people are taking pictures of Miles. They're like not
because
even being...
fabulous!
Look at this! Like it's just...
Sticks out like a sore thumb here in this train station. Oh well. There's quite a few people here, but look at the architecture. It's so cool. Oh, and the weather is so perfect.
Apparently Will is telling me everything leans, just not as drastically.
Yeah, everything here leans by maybe like 5 or 6 centimeters off center, but it's the leaning, it's the tower that leans the most, obviously.
Well, obviously the higher up you go,
yeah,
the more drastic that lean can
construction
be.
Work started in 1173, but ground to a halt a decade later when the structure's first three tiers started tilting. But then they kept going.
Now this is something. Check that out.
Anyway, we're just, you know,
chilling. We're just enjoying
just a normal Wednesday, I guess.
Feeling our light, you know.
I don't know, this building is kind of like in the way of our sun.
Sunlight,
yeah.
Sunlight. They're making dinner for tonight, Ken and company. Ken is the exec chef and
company.
No, I'm the sister. I'm the sous tonight.
You're the sous. Oh, he's the exec. Yeah. He's the, I'm so sorry.
Yeah. I'm judging him.
Maestro. I'm still the kitchen hand.
We have pasta and we have wine and we have awesome people and we have Will.
And that's Milo.
And we're off for another day of exploring.
So Ken has surprised us with a hike.
Well, it's alright, it's fine. I'm all for a bit of a hike, bit of exercise, work off the gelato, which I did not have. So, we made it to the top! Check out the view, bitches.
So maybe it was actually a terrific idea to come up here because this is like an amazing, I've never even seen that church before.
I've never been up here before.
Wow. Just more like magnificent views of Florence, and you can actually see the river this time.
Yeah. Oh, you can from the Duomo?
Yeah, like the buildings covered
up. Yes. 1, 2, 3. Okay. I think I got it the first shot.
Boom. Look at us! We're a cute Asian couple! Look, I have food for you!
Yeah, how did you like the garden?
Oh, the garden, I wanted to.
You were living.
I did not want to leave.
I mean, the gardens for me, I thought they were like structurally beautiful.
Yeah.
I mean, it was just like a lot of the time it was like, oh, that's nice grass. but like, you know, it could have been a little bit better. Like,
I was living. I don't know.
It was great. It was very like.
Well, he liked it. He just.
I liked it. Don't get me wrong. I loved it, but it was not like. I don't know.
Oh my god.
Like, I've been to like some gardens in Central Park. They're like flowers and all this stuff, and you're like, oh my god, it's so beautiful. Well, this was more like all the beautiful structures and everything around with the grass. Mm-hmm. That was beautiful.
I was just living off of the fact that of the history of this building. Apparently it was like a kingdom castle, like place where royals lived, and that this area that we were in was their backyard, and that this is where
they
would.
It's super casual.
Yeah, like this is where they would. Like it was fucking massive.
Yeah.
Like this is where they would chill out or do whatever, and I was just like. I don't know. I was just feeling the moment.
The most surprising thing to me or shocking thing to me is that somebody owned that at one time.
Yeah.
Like, that was somebody's property.
Yeah.
And it was huge. Like
the Medici was it, like owned it for a while.
And I was like, how does, that's like, oh, meet me in my garden at, you know, 7 p.m.
It was.
Oh, which garden?
Yeah, it was impressive in size, but as a garden, it wasn't that impressive.
They didn't cut it, so I'm just cutting random shapes out.
This, my dad says he's been going to bed hungry every night watching our Italy video.
The tortellini, so good. Really salty, but so good. So good. So good.
I can get that.
And then I'm gonna get my salad as my palate cleanser and then the tiramisu, and I'm just gonna die.
What?
I mean, not right now.
Wait, why don't we have power?
No, shit, guys.
That guy showed me where the
breaker is.
Yeah.
Your camera has such good light, though. We have no fucking power.
We have no power right now.
What's happening? This is the worst day of my life.
My video is at 87%.
I know, our internet went. Oh!
Yes. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That was so stressful.
We had no power for like 5 seconds.
We were all like shitting.
Good morning, everyone. So, we are having a moment right now because there's like.
there is some band that has released a music, new music video.
Catch me if you can. Catch me if you can.
Copyright. But we are packing up and getting ready to go to Florence, right? Or, woo, not Florence. We're going to Rome right now. And today's a pretty busy day because we have to travel to Rome, get settled into our new accommodations, and then do the meetup this afternoon. And then we have dinner tonight. So today is a pretty, pretty packed schedule.
Bye, apartment. It's gone. We have to leave. Goodbye forever.
We are on our train on our way to Rome right now.
There's RJ, editing the video.
You're waiting for a train. You know where you hope this train will take you, but you can't know. But it doesn't matter. Now tell me why. Because we're being engaged! Yeah.
And welcome to Roma! Welcome to Rome.
Yes.
So these are our accommodations.
Here's the kitchen. And then here's the bathroom. And laundry. And me, Ken, Miles, and Jake's room. And there's like a million bedrooms in here. Another one. And this one.
I'm so excited to eat.
You didn't even know.
No. What did I just figure out about this now?
That's amazing.
Modella.
Food.
Yeah, so good.
So good though. How's everybody enjoying their meal?
Feeling it?
With feeling it? Okay, that's good. That's great. Yes. Yes, yes.
So we gotta fuel up because we have a meetup later.
Girl! This is not even my plate and I finished it though. I tore it up. Thank you, Luca.
I think we're here, guys. I mean, I don't know. What do you think?
I think we're here.
Is this it?
This is us.
Yeah?
Oh my God!
So there's just a few people here. I mean, I don't know.
Is everyone there?
Is everyone here? Yeah, look, they're doing a selfie.
Everybody say slay!
Slay! Oh my God.
Guys, look, we're in a creepy railway station. We're on our way to
the apartment and it is like, we are delirious tired.
Look, you're so tired. Your eyes are so red.
I'm so tired.
So tired, me too. Are you tired?
We had fun. We had fun.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning. Afternoon, actually.
Yes, afternoon. I mean, we didn't eat dinner till like 10 o'clock at night or something. Well, we had second dinner at 10 o'clock at night. So today we are exploring Rome, and I think we're going to go to the Colosseum first, correct?
Yeah.
And I'm really looking forward to that, so I don't know what to expect.
Yeah, we're going through ancient Rome, and then I think we're going to go through Centro Storico and see like Trevi Fountain and Pantheon and stuff like that. So the first stop is the Colosseum, and then we have like, was lucky I have a guide that actually takes us on a tour in the book itself. So yeah, let's see what kind of trouble we can get into.
The first one I noticed was that there was a lot more graffiti in Rome. And I know that's like really superficial thing.
I was impressed though with the Romans. Like the train that we went on and how covered it was in graffiti.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I was just like, how in the frick did you get it covered in graffiti? And then the inside of the station, there was like the tunnel and the top ones were graffitied up. And like, you guys must have like got some creative ways to like hang yourself to just put
acrobats.
This thing. Yeah. Like.
Colosseum was like actually massive.
It was crazy. I was blown away.
You always see like far away shots of it, so you never really get a good perspective of how big it is. And then again, I've never really looked it up like online.
I think the funniest thing is it's just like there. Like you get the train station, you're like, oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Just like the supermarket.
We literally walked out of the train station. It was just there and humongous, and then on top of that there was like a parade going on, so there's like Roman soldiers walking through and like women. It was really pretty, so
that was cool. And then like going inside and just realizing how old it was, and it was really cool because it had information all around that told you about it, but you could almost, by standing there and just studying the structure yourself, you can actually work out how everything used to look, which was really cool because it's an experience where you don't actually need to sit there and be told exactly what it used to be. You can figure it out on your own. And it's...
There's also some, like, visual, like, help.
Aids.
Yeah, visual aids. Because they actually built a wooden floor, like, on a piece of the Colosseum to show you, like, what it would have looked like, as well as, like, a trap door that they would have used back then. So,
yeah. Oh, and they told me... someone told me, like, this really crazy thing that they made it, like, it was really well built, and they could fill it full of water.
And they would do boat battles.
Boat battles. Yeah. Which, when they told me, like, sea battles, the first thing that came to mind was, that, like,
swimming.
People, like, trying to kill sharks. Like, like man versus shark. But apparently, I was not right.
That would be interesting.
But can you imagine what they could have done if they had the boats in there and then put sharks in the Colosseum? Do you reckon they did that?
You know, they probably could have did anything at this
point.
Well,
they did it with lions and stuff.
Like...
Anyway, the Colosseum was great.
Yeah.
So we just got done with the Colosseum, and here is, I don't know,
one of the many exterior shots. I mean, we have to get really far away unless we want to like get a really good shot of it. But here is that's also work cut from a weird angle. It's the Arch of Constantine. And this is the beginning of the Roman Forum. And then the Palatine Hill is over here where Rome is rumored to have started. So I'm really interested to see the Roman Forum because it's apparently where like the city, it's like the city center of Rome was, and you know, senators would go there, and that's where the market was as well.
Where like everyone would go.
Yeah, it's where everyone would go. So
I also love how like animals can just enter it for free. Like there was a cat in the bottom, and there's just like birds just like, I'm gonna poop here because I can. See, like I would be arrested if I did that.
Vittoriano. Love it or loathe it, as most locals do, you can't ignore the massive mountain of white marble that towers over Piazza Venezia. Known as the Altare della Patria, Altar of the Fatherland, it was begun in 1885 to commemorate Italian unification and honor Victor Emmanuel II, Italy's first king and subject of its vast equestrian stature.
What?
AD.
So this is from 100, like negative 100?
No. This is from 118, I think.
Oh, okay.
Positive 118.
Pantheon is one of the most well-preserved temples in Rome. It has stood the test of time, and we are going to go inside. Tomb of Raphael.
Where?
It says to the left of the, wait, okay, to the, oh my god. Opposite the entrance of the church's main altar, opposite the entrance is the church's main altar, over which hangs a 7th century icon of Madonna and Child. So that's the box over there. To the left of the altar,
The
tomb of Raphael, marked by Lorenzetto's 1520 sculpture of Madonna del Sasso.
Down there, that is Raphael.
Look at these cute bitches. Cute.
We look like we just were in the center of a bukkake.
This bitch was sleeping and snoring too.
Well listen bitch, if you really have a problem bitch, you can go to the store and buy me some Breathe Right strips if you really that concerned. So, with that being said bitch, go get your money.
We're going out. It's Sunday night, so, you know, that's a normal going out night, right?
Could you imagine a club in the Colosseum though?
I love that we're in like ancient Rome and just like casually just going for a walk to a club across the road to get turned up. Oh,
yeah. Partying next to the Colosseum was the most mind-blowing thing.
Oh my gosh.
Because I felt kind of rude almost, because I felt like I was partying in someone's grave. Like,
I mean technically.
Technically, because a lot of people died there. But then it's
I'm sure we're partying on people's graves all
everywhere,
the time.
But yeah,
I mean, but someone probably died right here.
Okay, let's, yeah.
that. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
To point out that we haven't even been here for an hour.
I had a great time.
Yeah, and we danced the night away. I broke a chair, and the rest was history.
None unless you got buns, bun.
Good morning.
Good morning, Sabina.
Good morning.
This is Sabina's favorite bread.
It was
rock.
So good.
I mean, Sabina is bound and determined.
It's my breakfast.
Good morning, and it is a beautiful day in Italy.
I wanted to check out the forum appropriately, so left a little bit before them. Nick and Ken are off shoe shopping, and we're going to meet later on outside the Vatican, because that's what we are doing today. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the forum officially, so this is actually pretty large. This was once considered the capital of the world at one point, so let's see what they have to offer. Whoa, look at this. This is a pretty cool shot of some ruins. I'm not exactly sure what any of this is yet, but it's just a really cool shot of the forum. So this is a pretty cool sight. I mean, these columns, there's only a few of them left, but if you look at them, you see just how big the buildings here used to be. All of these columns right here. And like the buildings that used to stand here. And here we have, ladies and gentlemen, the Vestal Virgins. So this is where the Vestal Virgins lived. So we are up on top and we have a magnificent view of the Forum.
It's such a beautiful day in Italy.
Oh yeah, the Vatican was definitely some kind of experience.
That was a highlight. I thoroughly enjoyed the Vatican.
Yeah, it was filled with so much art and
famous art, really famous. And it's just like there, like, hi.
Yeah, there was, on one of them, was it the Thinker? It was just, there was no ropes around it or anything, and this extremely popular sculpture. And it was just kind of just sitting there in the corner.
Yeah.
And like, you wouldn't, like, I didn't even know that was it until people were like, oh wait, that's the Thinker. And
that
I'm
really
like,
famous.
I was like,
yeah. I mean, the thing about the Vatican for me is that I'm not religious. I never grew up religious. I never really learned much about religion growing up. So for me, I took the visit to the Vatican on face value completely. It was just breathtaking. Definitely a highlight this whole trip. It was so big and it was crazy. Yeah, it was definitely an amazing experience.
And there were so many people. Like, I was getting so, like, panic attack.
He was having heart palpitations.
I'm like, oh my god, there's so many people. What do I can't move. but, I mean, other than that, being inside there and all of the artwork and everything was amazing.
Yeah, that.
The ceilings. I'm like, what? It's just a ceiling, but it's not just a ceiling.
Like,
because this must have taken weeks and months and years to make.
To make, yeah, I mean,
not only are things drawn, but they're like woven.
Yeah, embroidered in it.
Like, how
does
I can't, my
one.
Mind does not.
And we are done with the Sistine Chapel. So I have to say that was pretty unexpected, the way that I felt about it. First of all, we couldn't record anything in there. They were
obviously
really, really strict about any photos or pictures going on. But I think that, I don't know, I almost feel like I was thinking about it as I was standing in there, that Sistine Chapel, first of all, it's not even that, it's not as big. It's probably like as big as like this area right here.
It's just a chapel. That's
yeah,
like,
it's just a
it's
chapel.
It's not a cathedral. It's not a church. It's just
it's pretty
a
small. And but the ceiling is like magnificently painted, and it's like, it's a magnificent work of art. But I thought, I just kept thinking that there are thousands of people that throng into that chapel every day to stand still, be quiet, look towards the heavens, and think about God.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm gonna turn the camera around in 2 seconds, and you're gonna see what I'm seeing.
Ready?
Oh, nah. I nearly fell over. What do you think, Miles?
Oh, I think it's amazing.
It's so beautiful.
Yeah.
right now we're using the tiny escalator.
Elevator.
Yeah, and it has doors!
Hi. Oh my god.
I got salad.
Yum. Super healthy. What kind of salad?
And now we're eating the most amazing food. Check out all the food. All the food.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, RJ. Good morning, Luca. So today is the final day in Rome, and we are making our preparations to pack and go to the airport and travel to Dublin.
Yeah, so it was the first time we met Luca, and I loved him. I wish he could have come with us to Dublin. And he was like, he was kind of like our tour guide.
Yeah, he was like our...
slash new friend.
Yeah, he was like our... tour guide and like our resident translator. Mm-hmm. I was learning Italian, which was amazing.
I felt so bad for him at some points because we were all like, hey, what does this mean? What's this? What's Luca. This? What's this? Luca, hey, Luca. This. Vieti, come on. What's show us everything here.
But yeah, it was really sad leaving him. But also, I don't know. I was really sad of leaving
Italy.
Like, I felt like I was ending a really, really awesome relationship. Like, that's what it felt like. I felt like I was ending an epic love story.
Mm-hmm. It was... with your stomach.
With my stomach.
Good morning, guys, and welcome to Dublin. Say hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
And we're heading to the Irish countryside today. I don't know where, I don't know what the plan is, I don't think anyone does. It's all a bit of a surprise, so you guys are coming along with us.
We have Connor, Kevin, and Martin picking us up at St. Stephen's Green, where we had the meetup last year, and they're gonna take all of us on like a countryside tour of Dublin and Ireland, so. That'd be pretty exciting.
The traffic was so disorienting. I felt like I was gonna get hit by a car like every time. Like I crossed the street. Oh, did Sarah want to say something?
Yeah, Sarah wanted to say something, so I'm trying to turn her off and it's not working in my favor. Anyways, the traffic was disorienting because we drive in the opposite side of the road.
I have like a mild like anxiety attack like every time like I saw a street and I'm like, oh,
First time Kevin was driving, and I was sitting in the front seat, their front seat, I guess, our driver's seat. And each time we would go over like a car or a bicycle, I freak out because the cars are going the opposite direction. I'm like, why are they driving the opposite lane? I'm like, why we're gonna get hit.
How weird is it sitting in the driver's seat, but not in the driver's seat?
Very weird.
We were driving and like every time we turned a corner and there's a car on the other side of the road, we were like,
the hills are alive with the sound of Miles J.
We made it! It's the Hellfire Club, the real one.
You know, Miles and Jake, just doing what they do best. Dance in the window of a ruined building.
Thank you.
Sabina knocked out.
Guys, I think that the Irish don't like us or something, and they're taking us,
out to a secret.
We're gonna die.
Murder us.
So where are we going? To a monastery, right?
Glendalough Monastery.
Glendalough is Glendalough?
Glendalough.
Glendalough.
Yeah.
With a K. Oh, okay, I thought it was like with a H. So Glendalough Monastery.
Insane. Dogs worrying sheep will be shot.
That's awful.
Dinner time, and it's past 8:30, and it's still like really bright out. And we're going to a place called what? Harry something?
Harry Lemon.
Harry Lemon, my favorite kind of lemons. And we're gonna eat there, because that's what you do at restaurants. Bye.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have made our way to the Harry Lemon. And we're gonna get some food first. We've ordered our drinks. I got non-alcoholic beer, I think.
Yeah.
Look at my meal. So it's chicken with some goat cheese and some vegetables and potatoes. Yeah, looking pretty excited about that. And then he got a Guinness pie.
Yes!
So what's in it?
I don't actually know. Beef.
Beef? There's like a stew.
Beef, mushrooms, and potatoes.
It's probably cooked in Guinness, right?
Dublin was amazing. Reminded me of Boston.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it reminded me of the East Coast of the United States, like upstate New York and New England,
yeah.
Boston area. It felt very reminiscent of home, so it was nice. Mm-hmm. And people were so friendly and so warm. They were so easy to talk to.
We had a bit of time to walk around the city and explore. Mm-hmm. I liked it because it just had a very homely feel. Mm-hmm. I walked around and I was like, I could live here. I mean, it was busy enough and it had everything you would need, and we walked around and it was great. Like, you could pretty much walk anywhere, and it felt welcoming and you didn't feel unsafe. And what do you think?
Yeah, I thought that it was really, I really liked the neighborhood, and everything was really nice to look at.
We're all heading out to have some drinks in Dublin, and I've decided I'm not gonna take my camera with me because I'm gonna have a good time.
Guys, we're joined by some very special guests. Look who it is. It's Eve. You guys haven't seen her in a coon's age. And look, Samantha. Yay, cool. So we're gonna be partying with some friends of ours from Ireland. And look, there's Connor.
Connor.
Look, there's Connor.
Connor.
There's Connor.
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 Hello.
Okay, so we're about to go pubbing. I don't know if that's a verb that people use, but yeah.
No. We're at location one. I had one cider at home, and we'll see what happens. Bye.
Look at this Guinness. It looks like chocolate milk, and it tastes like really bitter pretzel juice.
Yeah, so we're about to do the pub crawl. They're about to get absolutely fucking tanked, and I'm not. I'm going to be the mother of the group.
Okay, almost one Guinness down.
Look at this, there's lights here. There's light, and they're also green.
A few moments later.
So now we're leaving. Couldn't say goodbye to the apartment because we're in a rush. So yeah, and I have two bags I need to carry, so I'm gonna have to go now. Bye.
Good morning, everyone, and we are on our way out of Dublin right now. Oh, we're crossing. Okay. We're crossing. Yeah, so we're on our way to the airport to catch our flight to London.
Bye, girl.
Are we excited to be going to London?
Give me a nap, and then yes.
Yay!
Look at what we found. Oh, well, Lucas appeared.
Hi, how are you?
Fine.
Hello, guys, and we have officially made it to our accommodations in London.
This is the house. Oh my gosh, I just realized there's a kitchen here too. Mm-hmm. What? I did not even realize that.
So I don't think that we recorded much of dinner.
Where's Ken?
Oh, there he is.
In fact, I don't think we recorded any of dinner, did we?
Oh yeah, no, we didn't at all.
Yeah, there was a big group. We went to the buffet place that we went to before. Thanks. But yeah, we just got some, well, they got some groceries. And we probably just got water. I see how it is.
Gotta stay skinny.
Stay skinny. Zero calories. Yeah, so we have to go back. Shower, get ready for tomorrow because we have to leave the apartment by 8:30 so we can get to the space on time. We have 3 meetups that we have to do tomorrow, so pretty
fun.
Yeah, tomorrow is gonna be a long, long day.
Wait, that looks delicious. God. Is that like cookie?
It's chocolate. It's yogurt, chocolate, whatever. It's cookie, dark chocolate, and normal chocolate.
Morning, friend.
Happy that we were able to snag some space at the YouTube space to do the meetup because it made things go a lot easier. It was very efficient. We were able to see a lot of people and, you know, take some questions, ask them in a comfortable space where there were actually chairs. Mm. There was like nice microphone set up.
I love that, you know, when you're working with the YouTube space, you never have to explain.
They just get
what
it.
Is.
Yeah, they're like,
they
okay,
just
we,
get
we
it.
Have everything that you need, and you're like, oh.
Yes. Oh, so great. Like, and you don't know how many times at all the other places that they would just be like, so what is it that you do? And
yeah.
YouTube, there was none of that, obviously.
Right.
It was just, you know, they knew, they're like, oh, so it's a meetup. Okay, so you're kind of hosting a panel. Boom. Okay, who are your panelists?
Right.
Here's where, do you need this or do you need that? And we're just like, thank you, please.
Yeah, I think it was a little hard to find for people that were attending the meetups, but I think that overall they enjoyed themselves.
The meeting was, the meetup was amazing. We had a meeting.
Yes.
But yeah, the meetup was amazing.
It was awesome. Met about 180, about 200 people.
Everyone was so lovely. People had traveled from so far.
Yeah, they did.
I was like,
traveled from America, and then I was like,
yes. And also,
some of us are based there, but I guess
yeah.
Some people probably came out for you.
I had a lot of people come from like random spots.
Like where?
Like, and it was like Hungary.
Oh yeah.
But like no, but different. Hungarians. Yeah, but like different people that we didn't see at the Berlin one. There was so many. There's so many moments that, you know, I got teary and I gave him big hugs and whatnot. Yeah, it was awesome. Mm-hmm.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I know that this is a very strange way to start the video. We've had kind of a chaotic morning. We've been trying to orchestrate cars to get us to a photo shoot. We can't reveal what the photo shoot is for, and I hate it when everyone blah, 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 the secrets, blah, blah. But we're here, and...
Let's just say there's a reason we're dressed the way that we're dressed, though.
Looks like we're doing awkward poses, but these photos are turning out fantastic. Look at that. RJ is such a badass.
Thanks. God, look at how cute we look.
So we're back from a photo shoot, and I had a nap.
What? Do you mind?
Oh, hey. So after a refreshing nap and uploading two vlogs, it is time to go out for the club night. I'm so excited.
We did a photo shoot earlier, and now
it is literally like 6 hours long.
Yeah, we did like an interview after that, and then now we are going to the club night, the London club night at Ponana. What's my name?
Hi guys, so we're in the club right now, and here are some familiar faces. Look, there's Jake. Look, there's Christian. There's Trent. Where's Luke? Luke is in the back. There's Jake.
And Vinny,
yeah, there's Jake.
Vinny and Luke.
Yeah.
That was so fun. And the club was like really huge too.
Yeah.
The there was like three different.
Yeah. The club was pretty awesome. Ponana was pretty amazing. And the staff in the club were really friendly.
Mm-hmm. I broke a glass.
You didn't break a glass?
I did.
Get turned.
I like went to go hug someone and I knocked his drink like directly onto the ground. Like shattered glass everywhere. So Miles broke a chair. I broke a glass. Did you break anything?
No. And it was cool because then it was showing a more friendly environment. You know, I like that more because in the meetup it was very like, oh, I'm meeting you, sign this, and kind of like that thing, picture. And but in the club night it was like, I'm meeting friends.
I think it's because we had so much time in the club.
Yeah,
we had like 5 hours as opposed to like.
2-3 seconds.
Half hour.
This is one of the food corners. Like food all around here and there and everywhere.
Dutch pancakes with Nutella.
This is like
heaven. Gosh. Mm. If only there were sliced strawberries.
Yeah, they had sliced
strawberries. Oh, yeah? The most British shot I could ever get. Like, what is more British than this right now?
Vinny and Luke, yay! They are about to catch their train to go back home, yeah?
Yes.
But their train leaves in a couple of hours. Everyone else is, we were all supposed to meet at like 10 o'clock this morning, but that didn't happen after last night.
Like, then.
Are you really?
I was this morning, like.
Yeah?
It's ringing. Oh my God, it stopped. Are you kidding me?
Added in post-production.
How did I? Yeah.
Don't stop. Guys, it's a pretty sad morning. Here is like the start of the goodbyes. Say goodbye
so
to Stefan.
Oh, so
bye.
Sad. Bye. Say goodbye to Stefan.
He actually has a different flight than Lucas. But yeah, it's just the part I've been dreading for a while. No. This is so sad. He was so, like, part of our lives for, like, him and Stefan were part of our lives for the past month and a half. It's gonna be really sad to, like, not have them be a part of the shenanigans anymore. Yeah. The reality of living across the world from each other. Don't.
This sucks.
Don't. No.
I feel like, right now, I feel like a montage is going through my head with, like, as we go on.
Maybe not that song. Poor song choice,
but. Okay, sorry. My heart will go on.
Let's just leave the soundtrack to someone else.
And I don't want to say goodbye to you guys.
Yeah, like, I really don't want to say goodbye to you guys either. Definitely met a lot of really amazing people.
You know, being to so many different places and having so much happen, like, just having such a jam-packed, you know, 3 weeks, you know, the concentration camp, you know, I it was such a profound experience, and yet it feels so distant because we've had so much happen in between that and now.
I've had the most amazing time. Mm-hmm. And I've got to experience all these things with all these people that I love so much. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to describe it. It feels like a once in a lifetime experience. Mm-hmm. Let's talk real for a moment. Like, you know, we've spent a lot of time together. We've all gotten under each other's skins at some stage. But at the end of the day, like, we all love each other so much more for this experience. Mm-hmm. And it's really brought us all together. And to see what we're creating in a community, and what we're doing on a grand scale for the LGBT community worldwide, is very, very mind-blowing.
Yeah. And obviously, we have to say thank you to Sabina, because...
Yeah, the trip wouldn't have been possible without the magic of Sabina, so definitely thanks to her.
You know, she's just been... I mean, this was her creation.
Yeah.
And to see the amazing work that she's doing, and with the help of us, she's touching... This is her baby. This is her creation. And with what we do and what she does, we are helping save lives. We're helping inspire people. Mm-hmm. We're doing something meaningful in this world. And it's all because of her.
She was the root of this operation. Mm-hmm. Like, she was the foundation, the groundwork, and wouldn't be possible without her.
Yeah.
So.
And then all of the extra help that we had during the trip, Anya, Dennis, Luca, I'm trying to think, the people at the YouTube space in London were instrumental as well. It took me a long time to truly appreciate the last trip, and it's going to take me, I think, even longer to truly appreciate this one.
Just because there's so much to process. There's just so much.
This trip is going to change my entire life, has changed my entire life.
Yeah.
And my perspective on not only myself, but others and the way they live their lives and how I can reach out to people. And it's just been a really great experience.
I still can't fathom or wrap my mind around the fact that I'm in a different continent and people know who I am. People know what I do.
Meeting new people. I wouldn't have met you.
I know.
I wouldn't be able to, like, shake you every day. Like,
you're not leaving, by the way. You're coming on our flight. Okay. So I just... Yeah.
Just
I don't know if you knew that.
Same with that girl. She's coming. I actually did change your flight.
Bye, hunties.
Bye.
Stay huntalicious.
It's been amazing.
Subscribe. Thank you.
Okay, and did anyone like the chicken? Because I thought the chicken was lovely.